Hello and welcome to the third video of object-oriented programming in Roblox Studio. So in this video, I am going to talk about module scripts. So what module scripts are is they are a script that runs once and returns exactly one value. So in order to demonstrate, I'm going to go into server script service and create a module script. And so, as you can see, the basic format that Roblox gives you is a variable called local module, which is a table, as indicated by the curly brackets. I have a tutorial on everything about tables. I will link that right now. And a return statement. So according to the definition, what this does is it defines a variable module, which is a table, and it returns a table. So what this implies is that a module script does not do anything on its own because it has to be called by another script to actually run. So just to show you, we can put like a print statement within this module, and it will not print because this module script has not been called upon. So in order to call a module script, I'm just going to make a script to demonstrate. You have to first reference the module script. So let's reference this module script, and this module script is in game.server script service.module script. And then you have to use a special function called require. So local module equals require module script. You can put this in one line, but for purposes of this video, I will put it in two. So what this does is it finds the module script, and do not try to use a module script without requiring it first. You always have to require it to access its one value that it returns. So it requires a module script, and now we have it. So when this module script is required, everything, all of the freestanding statements they run. So you can see down here, it prints hi. So that's pretty useful if you want to instantiate some things when you are creating your module script. So there are two ways to use module scripts as a table. First way is to put all of your variables and functions within the parentheses, and the other way is to index them externally. So we're going to start with the first way. So as a normal table, you can put whatever values you want, like you can have a string, a number, even a function. Which you're going to do a basic function that will print something. Make sure to put your end. And if you plan to go this route, I would highly recommend spacing out all of your items in your array. So let me do that just now. And I'm also going to space out the function a little bit, so it just looks a little bit better. And I usually like to tab this over. So this is a lot easier to read now. And so you have all of your values, and these are here in the module script, and they are ready to be referenced by your normal script. So let's do that right now. So we're going to print module 1. And since this is an array, not a dictionary, there is no specific indexes. It's just all the numbers ranging from 1 to 3, since we have 3 values. And make sure to separate your items with a comma. So if I print module 1, it will print hello, and I'll do for the rest of them, and then if I want to run the function, I can do just module 3 parentheses. That will run the function. So as you can see, it says function called. Okay, so this is the first way and the easiest to understand way to use a module script. But the way I normally use it, and the way most people usually use module scripts, is indexing the items in the module externally. So what this looks like is doing something such as module dot number equals 1. So this is just an example. I have the module table right here, and I do a period in order to index something, and I have a string number. So this is the equivalent of saying module number equals 1. So this is these two statements are the exact same. The module dot way is a lot easier to read and to write. And you can also apply the same idea to functions. So you can do function module dot print something. And this can print something. And you can access these in your main script the same way as you do the normal arrays, but instead of putting something like 3, 1, 2, 3, you would do the string that you want to index. So I could do module.print something, which is the function. And I could run that, and it would print something. So in its most basic form, module scripts can be used as a global hub for all of your other scripts to call upon and get values and functions that they need. And what's also interesting about module scripts is if one script that requires it changes a variable, or if they add a function or change a function, then it will apply to the module script, and whatever other scripts that are requiring it will also get those changes. So in order to demonstrate that, I'm going to make a new script, and we can require the module script in line instead of having it in two lines by requiring it, and we do game.serverScriptService.ModuleScript. So this does the same thing as this script. The only difference is instead of getting the path or the reference and then putting it into the require, I put it into the require from the get-go. So it's just simpler, saves space. And so what I can do here is I can do module.number equals 5. And in this script, I can wait a second and print the module.number. I already have it here. It was prepped. And I can hit play. It'll have a delay of 1 second and print 5. So look at that. This script changed module.number to 5. This script waits for a second and then prints the module.number. I already had this here, by the way, if you just noticed that this popped up. And yeah, that's very, very useful for many things. You don't even have to change variables, you can just hold variables. And since our module is a table, you can add variables if you want. Like, you can index something new. You can even change functions, like set functions to something else or do something on the lines of that. And in the next video, I will talk about how to use module scripts with meta tables to actually make module scripts compatible with object-oriented programming in Roblox. So yeah, that is a basic overview of module scripts in Roblox Studio. In its most basic form, it is what I demonstrated here. But as you move up in complexity with module scripts, they are so much more powerful, especially when paired with object-oriented programming. So I hope you enjoyed. Make sure to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, please comment them down below. And I hope you have a good day. Goodbye.